Host Nora McInerney is back for season two of The Head Start, Embracing the Journey, a podcast from Ruby Studio and AbbVie. In each episode, Nora has real conversations with real people living with chronic migraine to see how they took action to understand this disease. So jump into the conversation for season two, a show that creates a little more space for empathy and understanding in such a complicated world. There shouldn't be so much hesitation around asking questions and asking for help. So don't wait. Join The Head Start, Embracing the Journey, and learn a little more about life with chronic migraine. What kind of programs does this school have? How are the test scores? How many kids to a classroom? Homes.com knows that these are all the things that you ask when you're home shopping as a parent. That's why each listing on Homes.com includes extensive reports on local schools, including photos, parent reviews, test scores, student-teacher ratio, school rankings, and more. The information is from multiple trusted sources and curated by Homes.com's dedicated in-house research team. It's all so you can make the right decision for your family. Homes.com, we've done your homework. All right, this sun season, evolve your sun care with new Banana Boat 360 coverage. With Advanced Control Mist, it's a new way to spray. It's an all-new bottle for an all-new mist experience that smells great and is incredibly light on your skin. You can even customize your spray. Like, to cover targeted areas, you just tap the trigger lightly, or you can pull the trigger fully for a long, continuous spray, ensuring long-lasting Banana Boat protection. Plus, it's refillable. From sweat-resistant sport formula to kids SPF 50+, this is sun care that'll come in handy when my kids are swimming, playing sports, when I'm hiking, when we're out at the lake, or whatever it is that we're doing outdoors. Shop Banana Boat 360 Mist at Walmart, Target, or Amazon. If you're looking for a new job this summer, have you considered using a recruiter? Your local Express Employment Professionals team is your one connection to endless job opportunities. With just one application, they can help you find a job at a company that fits your requirements. And as always, job seekers never pay a fee. Visit expresspros.com. To find the location near you, visit expresspros.com and reach out. Whether you're looking for contract work or a full-time position, let Express help. Okay, quote time. I'm so glad a lot of you are liking the quotes that we've added to the beginning of Tuesday's episode. I got some notes about that, and that's just encouraging because that's what these little quotes are for, to just inspire and encourage you. And it's something simple we can just throw in to the Tuesday episode. So I'm looking forward to today's quote because it's from a person that I really admire. And here's the quote. Imperfections are not inadequacies. I'm going to go ahead and own that I can't really talk that well, but that's fine.
And you get paid to do
it. I'm not inadequate, okay? Yeah. Imperfections are not inadequacies. They are reminders that we're all in this together. Brené Brown, shout out.
She's so awesome.
You know, if you mess up today, it's fine. We're all in this together. Like, nobody is perfect. Even if you think from social media or whatever it is, it's giving you, painting this picture for you that somebody's perfect. They're just not. And hopefully we can, I know that I'm probably guilty of painting that sometimes because I don't want to put up all the yucky stuff. Because also I don't want to be Debbie Downer. Like, I don't want to bring people down, but I also want y'all to know, and maybe the podcast is where I do a better place of explaining to you and sharing with you that the struggle is real. Chase witnesses at my house, you know, a lot. So he's like, yes, Amy's a hot mess. But, no. You know, the big question for me, I chose a Brené Brown quote, is because I am going to Austin. Well, I'm supposed to be. As of right now, it's not canceled, but Brené's, I got invited to this podcast thing and I was going to meet her because there's only like 90 people invited. But I don't think I'm going to get to meet her now. But I don't know. I'll keep y'all posted because South by Southwest was canceled for coronavirus and she was there as part of that. But her podcast is still separate. But a lot of the people were coming to be there for South by. So I don't know.
If it's a smaller group, you might be okay.
I don't know. But I don't even know that she's still doing it because even her guests, her podcast guests were in. They may not want to travel. So anyway, my big moment, Mary and I were going to fly because my birthday is what, tomorrow? So I turned 39, and that was like my big present to myself.
Was Brené.
Hey, Brené, put a bow on. You're my gift. But
it'll happen eventually.
Oh, did you see? Remember in Love? Did you watch Love is Blind?
Yeah.
Okay, that guy. How weird was it when that guy, the redheaded one, that got with Gianna or whatever, he put that bow on his wrist and he was like,
I'm your gift.
It was awkward. Yeah. I was like, what are you doing? Stop. Take the bow off.
I'm really bad at awkward moments in shows like that. Yeah. Like I have to like stand up and like walk around. Like I feel so uncomfortable. And that was one of those.
Yeah. So as of right now, I'm going to be in Austin, but not meeting Brené for my birthday. But I think I'll get to have dinner with my best friend, Andrea, from high school. So I'm excited about that.
That's awesome.
So shout out 39. And that's something I'm thankful. The older I get, the wiser I am, the more comfortable I am in my skin. Like I like aging. Like I'm ready for my 40s. And I never thought I would say that, but I should probably put that in my gratitude journal because gratitude challenge is still going on the whole month of March. It's not too late to join us. We're still doing it every day, going strong. And it's been really cool to see what y'all are thankful for. And I love that y'all are posting it online. Hashtag four things gratitude or tagging Shop Espoir or tagging my Instagram, Radio Amy. Like it's just really, really cool to see all of y'all participating. And we've been giving away like randomly $20 gift cards to the Shop Ford, like for people that post. And you don't have to post it in our four things gratitude journal. You could be posting it on just typing it in your phone and taking a screenshot or writing it in your own journal. And we're picking people and then just emailing them a gift card. That's so awesome. That's been fun. And then I guess before we get into the questions too, since I wanted to also mention that we still have customized Four Things zip pouches available. I got an email about that. So I thought I'd just address it real quick that someone, they thought they just missed it. Because normally we do sell out pretty quickly, but I think we've just had so much going on. People are buying other things. So we actually still have inventory of blank ones available where we can put your own Four Things on a cute little zipper pouch. And they're great for travel or just keeping in stocked things in your purse, like hand sanitizer and wet wipes because coronavirus, you can keep all of it could be your Corona pouch, your anti-coronavirus your corona four pouch. Things zipper pouch. But just wanted to address that yes, the customized ones are still available. I don't know how much longer, but they are. And then, you know, if you're on the website, we still have Austin Pimp and Joy stuff up. Still will benefit tornado relief in Tennessee probably for a while because it's going to take a minute to rebuild in Middle Tennessee just from the tornado. And then what else was that? Oh, Empowered Women's Tees. I guess since it's still Women's Month, we're still honoring and trying to celebrate women. And there's the Empowered Women, Empower Women tee with a little heart in the middle that Stashira, my daughter, designed, and all that's up. And you can go to radioamy.com to get any of that.
Awesome.
Yeah. You want to get into the questions?
Yeah, let's do it. All right. This first one is from Terry. Hey, Amy, I'm listening to the podcast regarding positive affirmations and heard you mention the series you're working on with the Well Necessities regarding eating disorders and that it'll be a separate podcast. I subscribe, follow your Four Things podcast on iHeartRadio, but how will I find this additional podcast?
Okay, Terry, I do have an update on this, and I'm now putting it back on the Four Things podcast. It was going to be its own thing, but it's one of those things where I had to just make the best call for myself and what was going to be less work, quite honestly. And I hate saying that because it's not that I don't want to put in the work, but we were wanting to already, we see the potential in it and we know it's going to be good. So we thought, okay, we'll just build this out and it'll be its own thing. And then this will be season one and then we can start on season two. But I was already feeling pressure for season two and season one hasn't even launched yet. And I was also feeling pressure of having, like, if we make it its own thing, then I got to get stuff in order and the sales team can start selling for commercials. It's like a lot that's involved. The artwork that goes into creating the graphic, and Chase was already helping with that. I just wasn't feeling it. Oh, and we had it called The Gray Area, and that was already, another podcast is called that. So we can't have that name. So then now we're thinking the name should be Outweigh. And then in the tag, we have something about the gray area of disordered eating. And just little things were just kind of adding stress to the plate. And I was like, this should not be stressful. This is something that's I'm doing because I want to be helpful to other people that might be going through some things I went through and other women are going through. And I don't want them to feel alone. That's literally why I have the podcast, is so that we can touch on topics. And it's not every time that we're touching on serious matters by any means, but when we do, it's so that we have a place to go and talk and nobody feels alone. And that's what Lisa, who's the Well Necessities on Instagram, and I want this series to be about. And we have real stories from real people. Is that weird to say? I mean, people are real, stories are real, but they're sharing their story. And it's like, they've captured it. We just had them record it on their phone and then send us the audio. And it's heartbreaking to listen to, but also I think going to be so comforting to a lot of people that don't understand why they feel the way they do about food, or why they obsess over food, or why they restrict, and then why do they binge. And they're not clinically diagnosed with, you know, anorexia or bulimia, but they do feel like they have to go to the gym for 2 hours if they eat something that maybe they shouldn't have eaten. Like, why do we do this to ourselves? Or why aren't we comfortable in our body the way that it is? Maybe we're built to be curvier. I mean, I could go on and on and on, but long story, I'm telling a long story to answer your question. It's going to be right here at Four Things. You will not have to search it out. That's another thing. Like, I've gotten more emails like this, and that was another stress thing, is I didn't want people to try to find it elsewhere, and then were they finding the right thing? And then honestly too, for people to forget about it, because this is going to be it's important to me, and I want you to hear it if you need to hear it. I've had moms email me that have kids that are struggling, like teenage kids that are struggling with body dysmorphia and orthorexia, and which orthorexia is when you just are consumed with eating healthy. Like, that's all. You won't eat something if it's not, quote unquote, in your approved list of foods. And that's a thing. Like, we shouldn't be trapped by that. You're in shackles when you're living that way. Now, again, if you do have a disease or an illness and you need to eat a certain way, that is a totally different story.
Yeah.
But if you don't, and you're living at this place of fear, which I have been there, and you're not eating out with friends because you can't control the ingredients, and you're not eating at a friend's house because you don't know how they cooked it. Like, that stuff is not good for our soul. And so I feel like it's important, and I want even maybe random people that don't even know about the series yet. If they're subscribed to my podcast, they're going to get it, and they'll hear it, and maybe they need to hear it. So that's another reason why we're not starting from scratch with a new podcast. So there you go. Thank you, Terry, for the question, and many others that have sent similar, but we read Terry's, so shout out.
Good call. All right, Megan wants to know, I'm always looking to have a great game night with my kids and family. I was wondering if there are any games that you and your kids love to play together.
Yes, we love reverse charades. We love catchphrase. These are good for adults and kids. We love Farkle, which is a dice game. And then something you can do with Farkle is you give everybody their Farkle name. Like, you just replace an F with the first letter of their name, make it F. Like, I would be Famey, you would be Face. And then you do that. And then you could have a Farkle tournament with everybody's Farkle names, and you can like get fun hats. We used to do that with my mom and some family friends. We would have Farkle tournaments, and that's just a really fun memory for me. The headphone game, Mary got this for the kids. It's called Hearing Things. And I don't know if you've ever seen on Ellen when she puts on those big headphones and then she has them read the lips and they try to guess what they're saying, but the headphones are keeping them from hearing what it actually is. It's like telephone. And then the thing, but you're reading the lips.
I bet that's so good.
Oh yeah. It's kind of, but Stashira is oddly good at it. Like, she can read lips really well. And I'm like, well, shoot, this isn't as much fun to play with you because it doesn't change as much. But that's a fun one. And then, like, if you're a family and you have TikTok, I know this isn't like an official game, but doing family videos is actually really fun. My family did one. Well, we did several because my sister and her kids were here for Thanksgiving. And we spent, you know, a lot of time making this Dolly Parton video, like 9 to 5, where you like put sweatpants in your arms become legs and they're dangling in the air.
I saw that.
But it was fun. It was a fun activity for the kids, and they get into it and they get dressed up and they're directing, and adults can do it too. And then we did a fun family Thanksgiving one, like to welcome to our house, Welcome to our house or whatever that song is. And that was a fun one. So I think, you know, it doesn't have to be a board game or an official game. Like TikTok can be a game where you pass it around and each person is in charge of directing and producing the 15-second
music video.
Yeah,
that's
fun.
A really good idea.
It's something that we've been doing and I like. Okay, next question.
All right, this one's from Amanda. How do you help someone close to you on the days that are meaningful to the loved one they lost? My father-in-law passed away 2.5 years ago from cancer on his birthday, Father's Day, anniversary of his death, etc. I know my husband is thinking about him and missing him. I want to acknowledge that I know the day is meaningful and I haven't forgotten about his father, but I also don't want to be pouring salt in the wound, you know? Considering you have experienced the loss of your mom, I thought you might have some good perspective on this.
Yeah, I think my sister and I try to be intentional about honoring our mom on her birthday and whatever that looks like for us. You know, each year it's been a little bit different, but I don't think if my husband were to want to bring it up and do something, I would not consider that salt in the wound. So your heart is in the right place. You mean well. And I think it's better to acknowledge it than to just kind of ignore it because you're scared it might be salt in the wound. But you can cook their favorite meal. You can, you know, during that time, read one of their favorite books, write a letter, like encourage him. This is something you can encourage him to do, is like write down thoughts and write something, and it's not going to really go anywhere, but it could be therapeutic for writing. I've been learning that with the gratitude challenge and writing, and having Allie Fallon on a couple of weeks ago in the Four Things podcast, where she wants people to be comfortable writing, and we're not all writers. Maybe what were some of their favorite hobbies? Like my mom loved to play Farkle. Like honestly, this year for her birthday, I should have a Farkle tournament because she was the best scorekeeper and I should probably keep score in honor of her. Her nickname during Farkle was Popo because she was like the police. She would police everybody and make sure that everybody was not, you know, everybody was awesome. On the straight and narrow and nobody was cheating at Farkle. So that's a way that you can, it can be fun. It doesn't have to be anything sad. Although it is a sad time and you can't help but get emotional when you think, because it just reminds you they're not there anymore. And when I was thinking about this, I thought of this Winnie the Pooh quote that is, if ever a day comes where we can't be together, keep me in your heart. I'll stay there forever. Winnie the Pooh. And I feel like that would be something special you could have printed and maybe framed, or you, if you have great handwriting, it could be special if you write it and then frame it and give it to whoever it is in your life that might be going through that, so they can just say, I was thinking of you and I thought you might like to know that like your loved one that you've lost is with you in your heart, as long as you keep that mindset. So I don't know. It could be too that he might need a break from life, like a getaway. Like, or if for me, that would be amazing. I mean, if my husband, like on my mom's birthday or something, I was like, hey, you want to go get a massage? I'll be like, yeah, thank you.
Great idea.
Awesome. This is so cool. Or run me a hot bath, or just know whatever they like to do to relax or unwind. Maybe do some of that too. Hope that helps. I know it's hard. I'm sorry.
Good stuff.
In every pair of Tecovas boots, you can expect handmade quality, first wear comfort, and timeless Western style. A great pair of Western boots will elevate a casual look or add a refined flair that'll draw both eyes and compliments. Tecovas boots are always made from premium bovine and exotic leathers, and with occasional resoling, they will last a lifetime. Now, the best way to shop for boots is at your local Tecovas store, where you're going to be greeted by the smell of fresh leather and a friendly smile. So come on in, grab a cold one, get fitted by a pro, and shop the latest styles. They also offer custom branding and leather stamping if you want to personalize your boots or fine leather goods. And stay cool in a short sleeve moisture wicking pearl snap. Or make your own shade with one of their classic straw hats, new in both men's and women's styles. And if you're planning to hit the road, Tecovas' ever-growing lineup of rugged and full-grain leather bags will get you where you're headed in style, and they are built to last decades. Visit Tecovas.com. That's TECOVAS.com. And don't go gently, y'all. This show is sponsored by BetterHelp. something that I've learned in therapy is that goals are really important. Like, it can really help you out. Like, when life is going so fast, it's important to take a moment to celebrate how far you've come, celebrate those wins, but also look forward to where you're going. Make adjustments for the rest of the year. And therapy can help you take stock of your progress and set achievable goals for the next 3 months, the next 6 months. I have personally benefited from therapy in so many ways. I feel like we'd be here all day if I were to tell you all of the ways therapy has helped me out, giving me tools to have in my back pocket for when I need to bust them out, coping skills, how to set boundaries. I feel so much more empowered because of therapy. So I'm very thankful for it. If you're thinking of starting therapy, well, give BetterHelp a try. It's entirely online, designed to be convenient, flexible, and suited to your schedule. Take a moment, visit betterhelp.com/4things today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/4things. Again, you're going to get 10% off your first month. From searching online to asking your friends and family, there are a lot of ways to look for jobs. But have you considered finding your next job through a staffing company? Your local Express Employment Professionals team is your one connection to endless job opportunities. With just one application, they can help you find a job at a company that fits your needs. Visit expresspros.com. And as always, Express never charges job seekers a fee. Express knows when companies are hiring, offers benefits and competitive pay, and in just one interview, they are prepared to present you to multiple companies who fit your needs. Express Employment Professionals places people in all kinds of jobs, including everything from customer service to warehouse jobs to accounting and IT roles. Let Express help you. And remember, there is never a fee for job seekers. Go to expresspros.com to get started and discover for yourself what it's like to have support in your job search. You can also start through the Express Jobs app. Download it today to search jobs, apply, and contact your local Express office. All right, you gotta love a place that makes shopping for gifts super easy, because heads up, Father's Day is June 16th and Macy's has got you covered. Their ultimate gift guide makes shopping for the dad or the dad figure in your life super easy. You can shop by price, 25 and under, 50 and under, 100 and luxe. You can shop by category, like cologne, watches, leather goods. You can even shop by gift lists. Like, if your dad loves to grill, then shop for grill master things. If your dad loves to golf, then you can go to the gift list that is for the golfer. I mean, really, Macy's has thought of it all. If you have a tech-savvy dad, voila, Macy's Gift Finder, again, has you covered with that. Top gifts include Beats headphones, JBL portable speakers, Nintendo Switch, and more. Top brands such as Calvin Klein, Tommy Hilfiger, Polo Ralph Lauren, Columbia, and more. Really, Macy's has it all, so don't be a last-minute shopper. Father's Day is June 16th. Make sure to check out Macy's.com/giftfinder to find a unique gift they'll love.
Okay, this one's from Sarah. Hey, Amy, I've had a long journey with birth control and wanted to know your thoughts. Can you talk about your history with birth control medication? Were you ever on it? If so, did it cause you to have headaches, weight gain, acne? I currently have an IUD and have scheduled to get it out next week.
Okay. Wow. No, I've never had an IUD. And I did take birth control at the beginning of my marriage, and it was the first time in my life. And I was also new to the Bobby Bones show, so I was crazy. Anytime I've taken any sort of anything to help, whether it was trying to get pregnant when I took Clomid or trying not to get pregnant when I took two different forms of birth control, I can't remember which they were. The first one I felt awful on. The second one, I didn't feel as awful, but I felt psychotic. And when you mix that with having to be on the radio every day and you're being recorded and it can live on iTunes and podcasts forever, it just wasn't a good cocktail. It wasn't a good mix. So I decided to get off of it. And then my husband and I haven't really needed birth control because we can't get pregnant. So, or maybe we will. Honestly, I keep thinking, like, what if I turn 40 and I get pregnant? I will be like, is this a joke? God, are you joking?
And if it was going to happen to anybody, I know. It would happen to you.
And our daughter, Stashira, is like, I want you to have a baby. I'm like, okay, are you going to raise it? Are you going to change his diaper in the middle of the night? Because I'm a little tired.
I can't even imagine.
I'm a little tired right now. I'm not going to lie. So I don't know. I could still get pregnant, but I know that that's so hard. I mean, everybody's bodies are so different. One person might react to a birth control and have no acne. Their skin might be clear. Another person might take it and they break out. My doctor, I'm perimenopausal, and my doctor wants to put me on some sort of IUD that releases some hormone that I need that'll help level me out, because my mood swings are crazy town and I'm not on anything. It's just my hormones and my Chase. I feel bad for you sometimes because you have to listen to me talk like this, but my cycle is really off and weird and like heavy or it's like no other in my life. Like it's all over the place. And my doctor's like, yeah, that's what's happening. Like this is what's going down. I'm early because I started experiencing the symptoms at 38, which most women do around 40, but some women before 40. And that just happens to be me. So my husband's like, yay. He literally, during one of my freakouts the other day, he said, so when are you going to go get that thing inserted inside of you that's supposed to make you better? Which is the IUD. But I don't know that I'm going to get it. So also, no, I shouldn't. I don't know what else. Like I get scared that later 30 years, we're going to realize these things we had inside of us were giving us, I don't know, cancer. I'm not trying to be scare anybody with it, because I could be totally wrong. A gynecologist would come on right now and be like, Amy, stop being ignorant. Don't say that. But I don't know. That's a true fear of mine.
Yeah.
So I'm overly cautious of what I insert in my body or what pill I take or anything. So, but if anybody else is perimenopausal and their doctor has done an IUD with them and it has helped, I want to hear from you. Please send me a note, fourthingswithamybrown@gmail.com, and put perimenopausal in all caps in the subject line. Cause like, I want to know what you're doing to combat some of the just hormone situations that are going down. And then really, I wish I could help you, Sarah, with your birth control journey, but that's really you and your doctor. You are the best advocate for yourself, and don't be scared to ask questions. Talk to your doctor, like play around with it, figure out what's best, or abstain.
I feel like these,
or have a baby. I don't know what to tell you.
Questions only come when I'm like with you that week.
Okay. Well, I guess that's going to be a wrap on today's episode. Thank you so much for always sending your questions. I just appreciate y'all so much. And we'll see you Thursday for the Four Things episode. Every Tuesday we do Q&A. Every Thursday we do Four Things. And if you haven't subscribed and rated and reviewed, like that would be awesome. Like take some time today and subscribe Four Things with Amy Brown. That way you'll get it uploaded to your phone right away. And then you won't ever miss a single episode.
Ever.
Ever. I mean, although I'm sure you'd be fine if you did. All right, this sun season, evolve your sun care with new Banana Boat 360 coverage. With Advanced Control Mist, it's a new way to spray. It's an all-new bottle for an all-new mist experience that smells great and is incredibly light on your skin. You can even customize your spray. Like to cover targeted areas, you just tap the trigger lightly, or you can pull the trigger fully for a long, continuous spray, ensuring long-lasting Banana Boat protection. Plus, it's refillable. From sweat-resistant sport formula to kids SPF 50+, this is sun care that'll come in handy when my kids are swimming, playing sports, when I'm hiking, when we're out at the lake, or whatever it is that we're doing outdoors. Shop Banana Boat 360 Mist at Walmart, Target, or Amazon.
Last season, millions tuned into the Betrayal podcast to hear a shocking story of deception. I'm Andrea Gunning, and now we're sharing an all-new story of betrayal. Justin Rutherford. Doctor, father, family man. It was the perfect cover to hide behind.
Detective Weaver said, I'm sure you know why we're here. I was like, what in the world is going on?
Listen to Betrayal on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
The Elevation with Stephen Furtick podcast was created with you in mind. This is a podcast for those feeling discouraged or needing guidance from God. Together in this podcast, we'll dive deep into scripture, uncover the powerful truths that will help you rise above your limitations and embrace your full potential. We're here to equip you with the tools you need to conquer life's challenges. Listen to Elevation with Stephen Furtick every Sunday and Friday on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.
Hello, acclaimed comics writer and notorious Scott Summers hater, Rosie Knight.
Well, hello, Emmy-winning podcaster and totally unbiased Targaryen royal supporter, Jason Concepcion.
Somehow the X-Ray Vision podcast has returned.
And like always, we'll be here every week.
You'll hear from TV writers, actors, comics creators, pop culture critics.
Nothing is off the table.
Listen to X-Ray Vision on the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you get your podcasts.